If you remember from, I know, last week when we said 3 times 5 equals what? 15. We had names for them. What did we call the 3? That was called a factor. The 5 is called what? Factor. And the 15 is called the product. So when we say list all the factors, if I say list all the factors of 15, let's list all the factors of 15. How do you get 15? You can get 15 by multiplying what? 3 times 5. You can also get 15 by multiplying what? 1 times 15. So any other choices? No. So when you say list all the factors, I like to put them from small to large. I got the 1, I got the 3, I got the 5, and I have the 15. These are all the factors of 15s. List all the factors of 24. Again, 24. Remember, we didn't cover negative numbers yet, so you're not going to see me use negative numbers. Negative 4 is 1 times what? 24. What else? 6 times 4, yes. 12 times 2. What else? 3 times 8. Anything else? So when you list all the factors, I put them in order, the 1, the 2, the 3, the 4, 6, 8, 12, and 24. These are all the factors of 24. Now, when you look at a number like the 24, and you're trying to list all the facts, especially when you have big numbers, like for example, if I give you this question, list all the factors of 210. Now that's a big number. It's hard to think of all the possibilities. I can go, well, 210 equals what? It's 2 times something. Is it 105? How did I know that you can divide that number by 2? I know I can divide that number by 3. 3 times what? 70. That's a 210. I know I can divide that number by 5. 5 times what? 210 divided by 5. 5 times 42. I know I can divide that number by 10. 10 times what? 21. I know I can divide that by 30. 30 times 21 divided by 3 is 7. 22. I know I can divide it by 42. I think 42 times, is it? Maybe not 42. By 35, I think. 210 divided by 35. 6, yep. 35 times 6. So when you have a number that's big there, one times 210, I'm not sure if I got them all. So how do we know what can we use for numbers? And that's where the next topic comes in. How do you know if this number you can divide it by 2? You can divide it by 3. I know you can divide it by 2. I know you can divide it by 3. I know you can divide it by 6 just by looking at it. I know you can divide it by 5, by 10. So we have some rules we can look at it to see if the number is divisible. Just by looking at it, you know if that number is divisible or not. Do I have a ruler here? Try to make a straight line. Should have a ruler, would be nice. I didn't think of it. There we go. So I'm going to give you a chart. The number is divisible by here. You can divide it by. And this is the condition. If, let's begin with the 2. How do you know by looking at a number if the number is divisible by 2 or not? Even, very good. What's even? So are you talking about the whole number or just the last digit?
Whole number.
No, the last
number. If the last digit is even. What does that mean, the last digit is even? It's either 0, 2, 4, 6, or 8. We're talking about a single digit. So it can't be 10. 10 is two digits. If the last digit is even, you can divide the number by 2. How about a 3?
It's odd.
Odd? 11 is an odd number. Can you divide 11 by 3? No?
No.
13 is an odd number. Can you divide it by 3? No. 21 is an odd number. Can you divide it by 3?
Yeah.
Yes. So what makes 21 different than 13? So divisible by 3. Divisible by 3, you add all the digits. I didn't plan on. So if the sum of digits is divisible by 3. We said 21 you can divide it by 3, right? What's 2 plus 1? 3. You add the digits. Can you divide 3 by 3? Yes. 18. Can you divide 18 by 3?
Yep.
Add the digits. What's 8 and 1?
9.
9. Can you divide 9 by 3?
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
42. Look at 42. Add the digits. What's 4 and 2? 6. Can you divide 6 by 3? The number is divisible by 3. So you add the digits, and if the sum of the digit is divisible by 3, the number is divisible by 3. We'll use some examples in a second. By 6, it has to be divisible by 2, by 2, and by 3. So you can divide the number by 2 and you can divide it by 3. That's for 6. We have them for 8, for 4, but for 7, too many things to remember, but you should know just the basic ones. By 5, if the last digit is what? 5 or 0.
Mister, would you write at the top?
If. So you can divide the number by 2 if what? And the last one by 10. I'm only going to cover these. How do you know if the number is divisible by 10? the last digit has to be what? Has to be zero. That's how you know, by looking at numbers, if the number is divisible by 2, by 3, by 5, by... There's 1 for 7, there's 1 for 9. But you're not going to remember them. 1 for 4, 1 for 8. Those are the basic ones, the easy ones to remember. So let me give you a stack of numbers, and I'm going to make a chart. On the top, it says by 2, by 3, by 4. It's not going to be nice and neat, so... to be a cal. No, I knew I have a ruler somewhere here. Here we go. Let me give you some numbers and tell me if it's divisible by 2, divisible by 3, by 6, by 5, by 10. So this is going to be the number here. This is divisible by 2, divisible by 3, by 6, by 5, and by 10. So this is the number. I'm going to write some numbers. Can you divide this by 2? Can you divide it by 3? Can you divide it by 6? Can you divide it by 5? Can you divide it by 10? And the first number I'm going to use, the one we just did, the 210, we did that number. I'll come back to it. Another number I will use, 5, 3, 1. 2,700. Four, 60. 2, 2, 8, 5. So I'm giving you numbers. So let's grab the first one, the 210. Can you divide the 210 by 2?
Yes.
Why? The last digit is even. Can we divide it by 3?
Yes.
Add all the digits. What's 2 plus 1 plus 0? 3. Can you divide 3 by 3?
Yes.
If you can divide it by 2, and if you can divide it by 3, then you can divide it by 6. So you have to have two check marks here to be divisible by 6. Can you divide it by 5?
Yes.
The last digit, 5 or 0? Yes. Can you divide it by 10?
Yes.
Yes. Let's look at this one, 531. Can we divide it by 2? No, the last digit is not even. Can we divide it by 3? 5 plus 3 plus 1. What's 5 plus 3 plus 1? 9. Can you divide 9 by 3?
Yes.
Yes. Can you divide it by 6? No. You got to have a check mark on both of these, Jamie. So I don't have a check mark here. That's no.
Oh, is it because 6 is divisible?
Yep. Can you divide it by 5?
No.
No. Can you divide it by 10?
No.
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 Can we divide this by 2?
Yes.
Can we divide it by 3?
Yes.
Add the digit, that's 9. Yes. If you have yes and yes, then 6 is yes. Can you divide it by 5?
Yes.
Can you divide it by 10? Yes. 462. Can we divide it by 2? Yes. Can we divide it by 3?
Yes.
4 and 6?
12.
That's a 12 when you add them. 12 divided by 3, yes. And if you can divide by both of these?
Yep.
Yes, there. No 5, no 10. Can we divide it by 2?
Yes.
By 2? This one?
No.
By 3? Yes, because they add up to 15. No check mark here, that means no here. Can you divide it by 5? Can you divide it by 10? No. So notice I don't have to do the math. I can look at them, So when he's trying to list all the factors, you can look at the numbers, say, wait a minute, I can divide it by 2. I can divide it by 3. And you can figure the rest of the factors.
That's a great help.
So that's why you want to know these things. You don't want to be sitting there dividing them, going, oh, divide by 2, divide by 5, divide by 6. Again, we have rules how to divide by 7. We have rules how to divide by 2. But if we give you a number, some crazy number.
Well, what about 8?
8, actually look at the last 3 digits. But then that makes the whole problem useless. You're dividing the number. Let's say I give you this number. Is 52197 divisible by 13? Now, I didn't even discuss 13. But that's a test, I mean, a question on the test, and it's worth 5 points. I don't want to give that 5 points away. How do you know if you forget all your rules, like is the number divisible by something? How would you figure that answer? Yes. Deshani, go ahead.
You divide.
Divide what, Jimmy?
Like the 1 to the 5.
You divide them.
You divide individually.
You divide the whole number. If there is no remainder, the number is divisible by 13. So let's divide it. 52 by 13. Is that a 4?
Yeah. No.
That's 4 times 13 is what? 52. No remainder so far. Bring the 1 down. 1 divided by 13. You can't. Bring the 9 down. 19 divided by 13. 1. 1 times 13. 13. What's the remainder? 6. And there's the 7. Could it be 5? 5 times 13. Is that 65?
Yeah.
Now notice there's a remainder. Once you have a remainder, is 52197 divisible by 13? The answer is no. Why is it no? Because you have a remainder. If the remainder is 0, yes, you can divide them. So if you forget all your rules, you can actually go through them and figure out if the number is divisible by 7, by 9, by 8, by 74, by 31. Just go ahead and divide them. You're not going to memorize all the rules. You can't. It's too many of them. But if you know the basic ones, the 2, the 3, the 6, the 5, and the 10, that's half the battle. Okay. Next topic for us in this section, we're still in this section, there's a lot of pieces. It is prime numbers and composite. So what's a prime number?
A number that can only be divided by itself.
Yes. And what's a composite number?
Isn't the opposite?
A prime number is a whole number. When I say a whole number, what are the whole numbers? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? No negative. A whole number greater than 1, actually. 1 is not a prime number. Greater than 1, that is only divisible by only divisible by, Joaquim, what'd you say? 1
and itself.
You can only divide it by 1 and itself. That's it. So what's a composite number? Not a prime. The opposite to that. So let's take a sample, say prime versus composite. Now, let's begin with the number 2. Is that a prime or a composite? Prime. You can only divide the 2 by what? By 1 and by 2. How about the 3? That's also prime. What about the 4?
That's perfect.
That's composite. You can divide it by 2. Right? 4 divided by 2.
Yeah, you can.
So it's not a prime number. What about the 5?
Prime.
Prime. You can't divide the 5. 6.
Composite.
7.
Prime.
8.
Composite. No, it's prime.
Composite. You can divide it by 2. You can divide it by 4. The 9. Composite. You can divide the 9 by 3. The 10. Composite. You can divide it by 2. You can divide it by 5. 11. Can't divide the 11. 12. You can divide it by 2, by 3, by 4, by 6. 13. 14. You can divide it by 2 or 7.
It's just a
15. Composite. You can divide it by 3 and 5. 16. I can divide it by 2, by 8, by 4. 17. 18. Good, composite. You can divide it by 9, by 6, by 3, by 2. 19. Prime. 20. Composite. You can divide it by 2, by 4, by 5, by 10. 21. You can divide it by 3 and 7. 22. I can divide it by what? 2 and 11. 23 is a prime. 24 is a composite. 25 is a composite. 26 is a composite. 27 is a composite. You can divide it by 9 and 3. 28 is a composite. 29 is a prime. Can't divide 29. 30 is a composite. 31 is a prime. I think you get the idea. 37 is a prime. So that's the difference between prime and composite. Why am I interested in that? One of the biggest pieces in fraction is something called prime factorizations. I was surprised when the book called this section Factors and Prime Numbers. Big deal. That's just introduction, because the big piece is really prime factorizations. So what is prime factorizations? Basically, remember, take the two words, put them together, prime and factors. Remember what a factor is? We said, for example, 12. 12, we said, it's 4 times 3. These are called factors. But now what they're telling me, I don't want you to use the 4 and the 3. I want you to use only prime numbers. Is 4 a prime number? No. Is 3 a prime number? So this is half good. 3 is good, but 4 is not. So how do we find the prime factorizations of a number? We take the 12 and we write any two numbers that if you multiply them, they answer 12. Don't use the one 12 is useless. Any other numbers beside the 1 and 12? 4 and 3? 6 and 2? You can use any one of them. I'll go with the 4 and 3 for now, then I'll do 6 and 2, Omar, after that. And I will show your answer does not change. Now, is a 3 a prime number?
Yep.
Yes. Circle it. Is 4 a prime number?
No.
No. Break it down to what?
2.
2 times 2. Are these prime numbers?
Yep.
Yes. So the 12 as prime factorizations is 2 times 2 times 3. All prime numbers. How many 2s do you see there? Two of them, and how many threes?
One.
As I said, some of you might take the 12 and break it down to 2 times 6. Is 2 a prime number?
Yeah.
Yes. Is 6 a prime number?
Yeah.
Try again. 6.
No.
Nope. Can Can you break the 6 down?
Yeah.
2 times 3. These are prime numbers. So 12 will be what? I see 2 2's circled there and 1 3. Yep. Is that the same answer? Regardless what numbers I start with, my answer is not going to change. This becomes really, really important when we go to adding and subtracting fractions, when we go to compare fractions to see which one is bigger, which one's smaller. Prime factorization becomes a lifesaver then. Let me try a bigger number. Find the prime factorizations of 72. Let's take the 72. Think of two numbers. If you multiply them, it's 72. Is 8 times 9 72? That's, to me, that's an obvious one. 8 times 9 is 72. Let's look at the 9. Is 9 a prime number?
No.
No. You can break it down to what?
4.
3 times 3.
Yeah.
No, I don't. 3 times 3 is 9. The 8. 4 times 2? 2 is a prime number. Is 4 a prime number? Break the 4 down. To what?
2.
2 and 2. Now notice all the numbers on the bottom, all circled. That means they're all prime numbers. So the prime factorization of 72 is, I see how many 2's? 3 of them, and how many 3's?
2.
That's 2 to the third, 3 of them, times 3 to the second.
Okay.
I see 3 2's and 2 3's. I'll do a couple more of these, then we'll show you how we use them. Find the prime factorizations of 80. Notice the last digit is 0. So I know that number is divisible by what?
10.
By 10, yes. So 10 times 8. Divisible by 2, divisible by 5. So I could start with any one of them. 10 is good. Is 10 a prime number? No, that would be what? 5 and 2. Both prime numbers. The 8, is that a prime number? No. 2 times 4, 2 is a prime number. 4, break it down to what? 2 and 2. I call this actually the tree, looks like a tree, you know, upside down, growing, you know. So when you look at it, how many 2's do you see there? I see 4 of them, unless I'm blind. And 1, 5. So that's 2 to the 4th times 1, 5. The last topic, the last piece in this section and that's finding the least common multiple. Least common multiple. We call that LCM. Some of you probably remember something called LCD. Remember the LCD? That's coming next class, fractions. Today is LCM. If I said, find the least common multiple, the LCM of 12 and 18. Remember, I'm talking about a multiple. Now, before I get to that, let's talk about a multiple. Maybe I should talk about a multiple. Now, the 12. Let's list a few multiples of 12. We call that multiples, not factors. 12 is 12 times what? 1. What's 12 times 1? 12. That's one of them. What's 12 times 2? 24. What's 12 times 3? 36. What's 12 times 4? 48. These are called multiples. The 18. What's 18 times 1? 18. What's 18 times 2? 36. Stop right there. That is your least common multiple. That's the first number, the lowest number, that you can divide by 12 and by 18. Now, every time I ask this question, what is the LCM of 12 and 18? People said 2. It's not a 2. 2 is a factor, not a multiple. So you're looking for a number out there that you can divide it by 12 and by 18. You can't divide 2 by 12. You can't divide 2 by 18. But you can divide the 36 by 12 and the 36 by 18. Now, this is not the best way to do it. I just wanted to show you this method. But this is not the best way. Then what's the best way to do it? Using prime factorizations. Especially when the numbers are really, really small or really, really big. So I'll do it with this one just to show you the same answer. Then I'll give you one and show you why it's not the best way to do it this way. So let's do the same problem. Find the LCM of, we said, what was it, 12 and 18. Let's take the 12, and there's the 18. And do the prime factorizations of each one. 12, let's factor that. What do we have? 4 times 3. That's a prime number, this is not. 2 times 2, prime numbers? Yes. So I have 2 twos and 1 3. Let's look at the 18. Want to put that phone away, please? 3 times 6. That's 18. Is 6 a prime number?
Nope.
No. Break it down to what? 2 times 3. So 18 is 1, 2. And how many 3s? 2 3s. Now here's the definition of LCM. The least common multiple is the product. The word product, we'll come back and look at that. Of all different factors. Each of them is raised to its highest power. Its highest power. And let's look at that definition. The LCM is equal. Product means what? The word product. Multiply. of all different factors. These are your different factors, the 2 and the 3. That's it. I don't see any other numbers. So it's the multiplication of all the different factors. Each of them, each one of these factor is raised to its highest power. Notice its own highest power. I'm not talking about combining them together. So when you look at the 2 here, you look at the 2 here. What is the highest power of 2 between them? Which one has a higher power, this 2 or that 2? This one.
Yeah.
And what's that power?
2.
Its own highest power. You don't add them. You go, this has a 1. You don't go 1 and 2 is 3. You go each one. This has a power of 1. This has a power of 2. That's bigger than 1. I'll use that one. The 3s. This has a power of 1. That has a power of 2. Which one is higher? The 2. So now let's finish the math. What is 2 squared? 4. What's 3 squared? 9. What's 4 times 9? 36. Was that the answer?
Yep.
Now for this example, you say, well, I like the other method better. Okay. Let me give you another one.
How was your own time today?
For a change.
Right? I didn't work like that.
Find the LCM of 20 and 21. I'll make that the last one. We're running out of time. Here's the 20. Give me 2 numbers if you multiply them. 2 and 10?
You said
4 and 5? Doesn't matter. Take the 20, which is what? 2 and 5. So the 20 is what? 2 times 2 times 5, which is how many 2s?
2.
2 of them, and how many 5s?
1.
The 21, 3 times 7, what do you know? They're prime numbers. So equals 3 times 7, which is 1, 3, and 1, 7. Here's my LCM. We said it's the multiplications of all the different factors. I see a 2, I see a 5, I see a 3, I see a 7. These are the different factors. 2 times 3 times 5 times 7. Each of them raised to its highest power, its own highest power. What's the highest power of 2? 2. What's the highest power of 3? 1, 5. 1, 7, 1. So now what's 2 squared? 4. 4 times 3 times 5 times 7. 4 times 3? 12. 12 times 5 times 7. What's 12 times 5? 60. 60 times 7 is 420. That is the first number that you can divide by 20 and 21.
Hey, 420.
Now, think about this. Watch this. If you were to do the other method, 420 divided by 20, you will have to write 21 multiples. You have to go 20 times 1, 20 times 2, 20 times 3, 20 times 4, all the way to where? 20 times 21. You'll need a paper the size of this table.
I used to do that in high school.
And the 21, you have to do it 20 times. So that's why a lot of people like this method to find the least common multiple. I'll stop here, and I'll show you next time how we're going to use that when you're adding and subtracting fraction or comparing fractions to see which one's bigger, which one's smaller.